Thank you very much. Our next composition is the Sarabande from the suite for unaccompanied cello number 6 by Johann Sebastian Bach, arranged by Ambrani for cello quartet. And we would like to dedicate this performance to the events at Ukraine where Russians and Ukrainians, who are brothers, currently have a big military conflict. So we dedicate this piece to all people whom we know in Russia and in Ukraine. The next piece on our program is a very unusual type of performance when the two different instruments, similar by timbre, but one is predecessor of the other, we should say, viola da gamba and cello meet in a duo. The story of this piece, which is the Fantasia by George Philip Telemann, says that the setup Ward knew that the set of fantasias for viola da gamba exists, but it was considered until the year of 2015, I believe, lost. And in 2015, the copy of this music was discovered in one of the archives in Germany. And we decided with Seth Castleton to make a duo out of one of fantasies. And I have to mention two things. Thing number one is that I have a very special feeling for this and for performing this special fantasia, because the person who is suggested those fantasias for me to be performed in this concert hall is currently in the concert hall, Alan King, who brought the music, the book with the fantasias, and told me to that it would be a great idea to try it on cello. And I performed all of them in this very concert series. And then later, when I was talking with Seth Castleton, who holds the doctorate in cello and gamba performance, from doctoral degree from University of Maryland, we decided that we would like to try how one of the fantasias will sound on two instruments. As you see, gamba is a very different instrument. First of all, it's a little bit smaller. Then it has, instead of four strings that cello has, it has six strings. And all of the strings are gut strings. Most of the cellos use the metal strings, so the sound is very different. And you might want to hear a couple of sounds just from Seth. Seth, would you like to play for us just a couple of notes or just a couple of open strings? Sure. Yeah, you see, so it's a very warm and very, very inviting type of tone, while cello sound is more kind of outgoing sound. We're going to play for you the first movement from the Fantasia number 5 today with Seth. And before we do so, I have to retune my cello, because the baroque tuning, baroque A, sounds half step lower than the original classical A that we use right now. Instrument is also ready for performance. George Philip Telemann, Fantasia number 5, the first movement. Thank you. So, as you see at Levin, we are experimenting a lot with different instruments. We have a collection of string instruments, and this gamba belongs to one of the instruments from Levin Music, where all of us teach. So, we continue our program with the... Just double check. With the Divertimento by Franz Joseph Haydn. This divertimento, also one of the 123 divertimentos that Haydn wrote for his employer, Prince Esterhazy, who at some point became very interested in playing a string instrument and learning a new for that for those times instrument, which was called baritone. Baritone has many strings, and among them, it had more than 10 sympathetic strings. And sympathetic strings are the strings that running under the fingerboard, and they help the instrument and the sound that produced by performer to resonate. And Haydn wrote, as I mentioned, over 100 of baritone trios, which included the this instrument and this instruments and cello, and Prince Esterhazy was the premier performer on in those trios. So this arrangement of the baritone trio number 113 we're going to play today for you with Seth Castleton and Max Wolfram Fischer, arrangement for three cellos. And before we start playing this movement of the trio, I have to tune my cello back to the regular A.
Thank you. So the next piece that we are going to play is from a beloved piece in the cello repertoire, the Elgar Cello Concerto, written at a difficult time in the composer's life in England, with the return and not return of some of his friends from World War I. Some people have termed this the War Requiem. And this third movement really exemplifies that emotional aching of loss and anguish, and is also appropriate for a time like now. And this arrangement is for four cellos. And so we will play with all four of our members the Elgar Cello Concerto third movement.
Thank you. Our next piece is a cello sonata in E minor composed by Bernhard, and he was born in 1767 and lived until 1841. He was a German cellist and composer and known as a renowned performer and cellist touring all over Europe. He made several improvements to the instrument itself, as well as the technique of playing, that has had a lasting effect on the evolution of cello playing throughout the centuries. It's been suggested that this cello sonata in E minor was a strong influence for the first E minor sonata by Brahms. In addition to works for cello, he wrote operas and symphonies and chamber music. He was very prolific, and you can kind of feel the operatic tendency of this piece. He's also known for possibly being the first to suggest half-size and three-quarter-size cellos for students. He's also been credited with reducing and simplifying cello notation to only three clefs, in case you thought that was burdensome. When Boccherini composed, he used as many as six clefs in his composition. So aren't we lucky? So we are only now using bass, tenor, and treble clef. He's also thought to have been one of the first cellists to perform from memory, which was a skill praised highly in his day and is considered kind of standard for us now. So we're excited to present this to you at this time.
Thank you.
And we decided to end our program today by the probably the most popular, one of the most popular pieces ever written by Manuel de Falla, the ritual fire dance from the ballet The Bewitched Love, arranged for four cellos by Emilio Calon.
Thank you.
Seth Castleton, Aaron Ryder, Max Bowen Fisher, and Vasily Popov. Thank you very much for coming today, and I'm looking forward to seeing you next month, and look for the announcements on the webpage and through my email. Because I'm not sure yet who will be performing in these concerts. I'm in touch with the potential performers. Thank you very much for coming today and looking forward to seeing you soon.